This is a video of Siddharth Kararwal.
Basically, tell people that
yeah.
This is under your control.
Yeah.
Yes.
And that I am basically
just a tool.
Just a tool.
You are a tool.
And basically, I. This is.
I've taken the whole control of the edit table.
Yes, and you want the footage to be.
I want the footage to be.
Uncut.
Uncut.
And
the way it is
and that is the true representation of you.
Yes,
it hopefully it is the true representation of you.
Yeah.
And that you are going to this is
I kasam khata hu for whatever you said and I agree to it.
No, not what I agree to it.
We all agree to it, as in I convinced you.
Yes.
This is the uncut footage
that you want to show.
Yeah, that I want to show.
Yes.
On screen.
Yes. And I am giving.
And there is no interference from Vaibhav Raj Shah Singh. See?
Okay, so basically, this is it.
This is it.
Okay, Siddharth, just talk about how, whatever. College ke baad, what do you hate about college?
What do I hate about college?
Speak loud. What do you hate about college?
See, first of all, I don't like this pedestal. I mean, this is where we are standing right now. There are usually a lot of teachers here. And then from here, it's like, you know, you just record whatever is happening around, what people are doing. So, basically, kids here don't have a time to be themselves. I mean, they don't. For me, it's like, you know, I can't work under surveillance. I mean, you can't work under surveillance. So that is something which I really don't appreciate. But this is, I guess, end of it, just the space management. There was no more space, so they created a kind of a pedestal where teachers can sit and have a view. I mean, just have a view of what people are doing each other. But I don't think that is happening. It is. Like, they also have to understand the other side of the you know, the conversation where I mean, I can bet, I mean, they are just trying to concentrate on what they're doing. They can't have that kind of a freedom next to them. I mean, you know, not like a, like, you know, they can't jump around or something. That's a thing. But like, you know, idea-wise, I mean, I can, you know, you can just do whatever if you feel like in the college. If you don't have that kind of a surveillance, every, like a check on you, on your head every time. That's something which disturbs me the most, and this is where very recently done, and I wasn't even there when this thing happened exactly, and I really passed out. So I had the separate studio which is right next to it. So, but here, I mean, right now, I mean, I see a kind of a tension being built up inside. I mean, I'm after running from so many places. I mean, you come back to a college, I mean, I mean, to just to start work, and then suddenly you see, like, you know, it's not your own space, end of it. And this kind of a view, this, you know, it's like, wo koi target mein ho aap ek, and this, like, if you do whatever, so boom, karke blast over, and then things would just blast over.
So, what you mentioned, what you didn't like about this, so how did this place affect your work? Like, how did you change? I mean, how did you start? Wait 1 minute. How did you start changing your materials? And because you see this clay, so start by saying you can see this clay around, la 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 la, and my work is different hence.
See, I guess.
One minute. Nadira. I'm just doing a small interview of seniors. Can you just ask them to just for 10 minutes keep volume down? They'll feel upset. They won't listen. No, just ask him, tell him we're shooting. See, I'm doing a shooting of the seniors who's passed out. I'm making a document.
Wait, Bulana is going to say, Bulana is going to say,
Devashish, bhai.
Devashish.
Hey, MSU ka documentary.
Wait, dude. A little volume down to 5 minutes.
5 minutes till it's request.
5 minutes of silence.
MSU ka shooting ho raha hai.
कोई हमें सीधा शूटिंग नहीं हो रहा हम बस तो 5 मिनट बोल दिए बात कर रहे इट्स रिकॉर्डिंग रिकॉर्डिंग प्लीज जस्ट
5 मिनट प्लीज वॉल्यूम डाउन 5 मिनट प्लीज जरा वॉल्यूम डाउन
जस्ट ट्राइंग टू रिकॉर्ड समथिंग पांच जस्ट 5 मिनट साइलेंस
हाँ सो बेसिकली How did your you start working with clay, and then how does your
see every person who comes here, they have a kind of a set of a course which happens. You have to start with
no. Don't say here. Say everybody who comes to sculpture department
institution.
No, no. Say everybody who comes to an institution, because people don't know. We're not doing this MSU anti MSU thing.
Anyone who comes to an institution, okay. Do it again. So like, if you enter an institution, any kind of institution. They said tools, I mean, you have to follow. But apart from the said tools, what's the idea of an art institution here? I mean, I guess should be, according to me. If I open up my own art school, I would just kind of, you know, just take the course which is even happening and then try to change it a little bit, just modify it a little bit. I'm not saying, I'm not questioning the course, or I'm not questioning the idea of how should people teach art. It's not about that. It's about, like, I've been here, I've been to an institution. And I've studied here, and for 4 years, I mean, it is a very cool, crazy exercise. You have to work in all mediums, you have to take, they teach you how to take molds of stuff. I mean, you know, for the first time, if you take a mold, it is a like a feeling in itself, as in, you know, you see something and you have a replica of it by yourself. It's something like, again, I would try to say, like, you know, if you like a t-shirt, you take a mold of it. You know, you'd go buy another one. So,
but what you learned here essentially is then the anatomy, and then your outer skin is what you are working on. So basically,
yeah, it's here as in where you have all the freedom to do whatever, and then later we are expected as students to build up our own kind of a language where we work in different mediums, and you choose your mediums. There are n number of mediums available, as you see inside. I mean, you see the maquettes around. You see so many things happening, then you just have to pick one and then start working. So it's not about me working or not working in clay, and why I chose clay and why didn't I choose clay or something else or plaster. It's about myself. I mean, I have tried to build up myself in a way where I hate making armatures, I hate making clay. I mean, the whole idea, if someone gives me a packet of clay with a made up armature, I would like to apply it in any direction I want. But that pehle ka process of making it, that's just my personal thing, I don't like it. I mean, it's not about that I'll get dirty or something, but at times you don't feel like because you're busy somewhere else and you just want to just kickstart a work. So,
what is then your, let's do that heavy duty power lens. What is your, and forget that you're in college.
Yeah.
Just what, how do you think art should be?
Art should be a little more human, I would say. I mean, it shouldn't, the people shouldn't have the idea of mystifying art. I mean, as in, oh my god, art.
Who is your ideal artist?
I mean, I haven't decided. There's so many. I mean, because, you know, and you can name them as in with what you see that moment. I mean, for some time it was, you can say, Nagji, sir. That is something, you know, like he's been making so massive, humongous sculptures out of stone. And look, like, you know, so you at the same time look at his age, look at the way he works and the schedule he follows, but that's him. I mean, so, you know, so we graduate or we start thinking of ourselves, and then whoever fits in that bracket becomes our favorite. And then you want to, you know, just continue building up your favorite list every time. So you can say, I will try to call 100 different artists as my favorite artists, because each and every person will have their own self to it. So,
do you like monumentality?
Yes.
Say that. Because
I mean, it starts with monumentality. As in, if you start working, first thing, any person on earth would, if he makes something, he wants to make it big. You know, so that no one misses the eye. I mean, no one misses the volume of it, and then later you try thinking about the idea behind it and the way it would fit in. That's much later. I mean, that's much later when you try to make it your profession. I mean, as in you try to also sell things, or maybe, you know, just put in a medium, I mean, in a museum or something. You create your own museum in your house, but again, you have to control your emotions to a bit, maybe just by squeezing it a little bit. That's the first step, I would say. And then later, just blow it up wherever you feel time, wherever you see the right space to do it. I just want to blow things up. I mean, like, if you give me the whole faculty to work and you give me the monetary support next to it, and then the, of course, the labor force. So I would like to blow it up.
The labor force too.
Yes. I mean, I'm not making clear again. So I'm not doing the Mal Saman which is involved inside. There is a very thin line between, you know, being a creator and then doing the mehnat which goes behind creating something. So, I mean, it's just my personal choice. I choose the other side of it, where I just want to be called as a creator of an object and then shoot things ahead, not all exactly follow a very traditional way to build it up. Because at the same time, I mean, like, the, like, some time back you were talking about like this idea of a man who had a balloon. He put a, like, a second hand camera next to it, as you told me, like, you know, the whole discussion we had, and then he would just leave the camera, and the camera would go 33 kilometers in the air, and he would get capture better pictures than NASA. That is something which any person would, you know, appreciate and say, wow, I want to take this chance where I can come up with something which is easy going, which is like a very miniature thing, and then it captures much better pictures, it captures much more information than what, like, so much cash involved inside and something like that, you know. So, yeah.
So if let's ask you something else, to ask you something you want to say. Okay, tell us something about your next project.
Next project.
Something that is coming up. Say something that is coming up.
What's coming up is, well, I have a house. I mean, I have rented a house, which is where I want to involve artists inside. And then, you know, the idea is to rape a rented house. So before leaving it, it's a very weird way to say it. As in, like, you just fuck it up in a way. Not fuck it up, but as in permanently or something, but just, you know, just for a twist of it, just for the twist, just for the sake of it, call it okay, I fucked the whole space. And I've chosen my house as in because it's I guess it, no one comes inside first of all. I mean it's the, from three sides, it's a very weird construction. From three sides, you cannot see anything from outside. One side is just a huge land which is just empty for like the longest time now. And it's back facing from two sides, as in like people can't see directly inside the house. So I chose myself, as in I for a moment I realized I have discovered a place in the city where no one gives a shit what is happening inside, because no one enters. First of all, no one even care a damn what is happening inside. So I want to involve people inside, involve artists, involve kids, involve everyone inside to, you know, just come and do something with me inside this space where I have, which I have provided to them, and they have all kind of freedom to kind of do anything.
Okay, 10 minutes.
So it's not about creating a nuisance. I mean, it's not
your shop.
Yeah, it's not about creating a nuisance, but also developing our own practice where this house is a space, end of it. It's an empty space. I give someone an empty space. It can be any space. It can be white, grey, black, a gallery, outside road, wall, garden, museum. But it's a space. I mean, and it's an exercise for me, first of all, to develop something inside that space. And I want to challenge everyone else, can you be a part of it? Like, you know, like, I'm doing it.
You have a show coming up now.
Yes, I have 3 shows coming up. One is in, like, all of them have, like, a gap of a month each. So, this time, what I want to do is follow a kind of a process. I mean, you know, we are, like, ourselves, we are creating something. We don't have a set schedule. So we have to make things accordingly. You have to make a timetable for yourself. So every day you have to have that kind of exercise. I mean, I follow an exercise where, okay, for one day I will just sleep. So that timetable goes, okay, like, I will never get up. One day I will just watch television. One day I will just work. One day I'll just cook. One day I'll do something else. I mean, I'll just roam around. I'll go drink somewhere. I'll run on the streets. So every day, I mean, for a month, you make a timetable for yourself. And then you just keep doing it, because you don't have to answer anyone. You don't have to say things to anyone. You don't have to follow a schedule. Remember, this is the schedule, inside a schedule, where you have to do something at least. I mean, just surviving bit, and this every other aspect is very different. You have to control your own head first, because it just goes in such weird directions. I mean, you see something one day and then just start following that person.
But then you're making it go that way.
Yeah, but I'm actually
because
making it
you said,
go that way. I mean, it depends on person to person.
See that line again. Yes, I'm making it go
that way. I'm trying to make it go that way where, you know, like, you follow your own schedule. It's like, you know, a timetable inside a timetable.
But earlier you said that talent is like a wild horse, it's like a wild beast, if you don't hold
talent
on to it.
Is, yeah, this is what my teacher used to tell me, like, see, it is like, no matter how talented you are, but if you do not perform well, it's nuts. I mean, it's of no use. I mean, you just keep it to yourself, keep it in your pocket, and just get the fuck out of here. You see, so you have to, like, keep performing. I mean, this is our way to do it. I mean, this is my way to do it. You have to.
So making art every day for you is not...
I mean, I love making art every day. It can be anything. I mean, it shouldn't be like I have to show it to people. I mean, a pressure cooker with 2 glasses makes a face for me. So if I'm cooking and I see a cooker with a long nose and I imagine it like a long black beak to it and put 2 glasses in on the top, it becomes like a sculpture for me.
I have the footage of that.
Yeah, so I mean, that's what we were trying to do the other day. I mean, you were here and it was just a special pole dance performance which I did for you. Okay, I was just trying to show off, you see. See, saying, okay, well, I can do something in a day. Not even a day, in half an hour. So, and I'll try to prove it. But there's nothing to prove. I mean, I'm trying to prove myself, okay, I'm doing it. So, you know, so that's how it rotates.
Do you have any something that even you know you can't pull off, but it's an idea in your head stuck for a long time. Like, you know, like this fucking crazy, like you want to buy the world, you want to make a sculpture on moon. Something as fucking crazy, forget the money, monetary aspect.
Yeah.
What is the most motherfucking wild thing you wanted to do, which it could be spontaneous?
Wild thing I wanted to do was just to control my head, first of all.
I'm sorry?
I mean, I was trying to control myself. I mean, that's the basic exercise. I mean, that's how I operate. As in, it is a kind of a, it's not, I won't call it a meditation, but it's something which is on the similar grounds where you do something just also by proving yourself. You just every time you're just trying to, like, you know, shake your head. So because it is about, for me, it's about drasticness. I mean, how drastic a person can get while in a regular daily mundane life. I mean, how I forgot.
How, why do you want to be drastic? I mean, like, you are always drastic as a child.
No, so that also matters.
Say that again.
I'm not very drastic as a child. When I was a child, as a child. But yeah. Now I really want to be one.
So that's why. What did you look at because of which you felt you have a mundane lifestyle and now you should up it? Because there must be something.
See, I guess it's just the way of thinking. I mean, if I call myself mundane, बेशक मैं रोज जाके एक बंजी जंप करता हूँ या मैं if I keep doing bungee jumping then it will become very mundane thing. So you see, so at times it was, I mean, you've just been jumping around all your life and then you just want to control yourself. I think this thing is exercise, again an exercise for myself. No one else has the right to kind of question this. I mean, because it's, everyone has their own kind of a set up, like a box where some people just want to just attract things towards them, some people just want to leave things and just go towards a very shant, seedy, meditative life. But I believe if I've not done it, how will I believe? I mean, you know, there's no proof I've done it, and so I really want to do everything, explore all mediums, explore things around. Like, it's not art, it can be anything. I mean, art is something which I happen to know, or I happen to be in a university or institution where...
Fuck the institution.
No, I mean, I love doing it.
Don't say, so, I don't know why you have this institution.
Institution, yeah. Memory. Institution ka
what
funda
I'm, what
is,
I'm basically asking is, do you consider art as a conclusion? Like, do you believe in conclusive art? Like, I made this and this means this. Because
I thought, you know, like, the moment I achieved a horse out of shirts, I mean, this is one of my sculptures. I used 200 shirts and then the whole idea was very different. I mean, I wanted to collect shirts from people and then do it.
Just tell me, so, what are the materials are there? What are all the materials used in that shirt, like a cookery show?
Okay, there was, like, the horse is very, like, again, very, very, what do you say? It's not, like N number of materials inside. It's this iron, wax, shirts. So, the, what do you call it? The process of collecting those shirts was very important. I mean, that medium makes me, like, you know, rethink about the sculpture every time. I mean, because whenever I used to collect shirts, I mean, you can't get white shirts at the same time ek hi store pe jaake, and it gets too, you know, expensive to buy, like, branded shirts. And like, bhai saab mujhe 100 shirt de do. You're not good there to bargain with brands, as in, you know, it's, so to collect those, I had to go to every random people, people who, like, provide surplus shirts in the city, and talk to them about, मुझे 500 shirts चाहिए, मुझे 200 shirts चाहिए, आप एक shirt कितने की दोगे? I end up buying just 200, but just to negotiate, I had to, like, go the other way around where I would like to say, give us math,
and
I was just trying to just, you know.
Why shirts?
Shirts is, I guess, not shirts, any kind of a piece of cloth for me. I've been working with skins. I mean, like, I used to make skins, as in, like, you know, just not real skin, but just the texture of skin. I mean, you how you try to peel things off, so that peeling bit. So shirt is something, if it gets dirty, you just remove it, wash it. We have the advantage to kind of just rewash it and dry clean it.
Is that how you think? Of only skins?
Only skins, yeah.
And through, like, skin, what
through
do you
skins,
say?
I was...
No, repeat it, just, I overspoke. I feel.
So you got a question inside, yeah, that's something which I'm missing also.
No, through skin, what do you trying
through
to say?
Through skin, I mean, I'm not saying anything. This is just me, myself, trying to wrap myself into a different kind of a color, a different kind of a costume every day and presenting myself in front of someone or a mirror. So, okay, now today I'm something different. So I wear green. So today I feel like yellow. So today I feel like a text. So today I feel like a balloon.
But actually, it's not supposed to mean anything. That's not the purpose of it.
So it's not something, I mean, so your collection of those shirts, like I was working with these army shirts. So now you go to these issues later. This is something like, as in if I have a, there's a store which sells secondhand army shirts. So you see, now if you understand this, the army shirts, it has like these sweat marks everywhere because it's a kind of a material which is not being suited here. I mean, it's a kind of a woolen, like heavy duty stuff, so that it doesn't tore off, or it's for like, you know, different purpose. But it, to wear it every day, I guess I won't be able to wear something like this every day because it just collects so much sweat, it makes you itch, and I don't know. So what happens is, like, the government, they have this, I mean, if you put like old shirts, give them the old shirts, they will replace it for you. They can give you new shirts, they give you new shirts for very, very cheap, kind of just same like $100 or something. So army fellows, they don't have to buy shirts on a very regular price.
It's subsidized.
It's all subsidized, as you see. So I managed to get these shirts and these old blankets, which are just been used. So, and you know.
So you definitely then, therefore, you have found you objects
start,
at home.
And then you no, start thinking about it.
You like the idea of found objects, basically. Somewhere, like, there is always a found object. You don't want to buy things, you want to buy things at subsidy. So you have that.
I mean, I don't collect material, I try to collect props, you see. So it's, for me, these are props. I mean, each and every object, each and every shirt
props.
Talk about its subject, as in, like, you know, like a army shirt has a mark here, maybe it just like because he was walking somewhere and nail attacked it. But if you start imagining, if you talk about the glorification of a lady, like a soldier, and then you see a cut here, so you start imagining things in a different way. So I'm not saying that कोई वॉर से वापस आके मेरे को फटी खून भरी शर्ट दे दी, but it is something like, you know, you just have to build up stories around. And prop itself is something, it has a very good, you know, like a very good kind of a covered story base to it.
It's basically the history of a found object.
Yeah. So that history is
Say it's a history of a found object.
Yeah, the history of a found object is,
which is converted into skin.
Which is not really converted into skin. I mean, that history, I'm not talking about the shirts right now. I'm talking about a material history. I mean, like, it has to have a cultural context to it, or it can be a industrial context. I mean, how in production the thing has been made, and now I get it for a 50 paisa. So if you see a cap, like a bottle cap, so the labor goes behind, like, you.
Sorry, completely verification.
What was I saying?
Your mother and father wear these safari suits, and your mother wears something.
No, not as in, like, everyone go, like, in this kind of a setup where they are supposed to work in a setup. So they give, just to unify it, like, you know, like those stripes. So the clown thing. So that actually came up from one of these war stories. I mean, I was some discovery thing I was going through. It was about these the Nazi costumes when they were about to, like, you know, kill them, or like, you know, suffocate them to gas. So they used to have these kind of markings on them, as in, okay, these are the striped guys who are going first, now these are the Czech guys, or the Czech, I mean, they're going next. So you have these numbers, and since, so I also try to kind of get that kind of a approach in my work, where, you know, like, if you have some kind of a identification attached to a shirt, so, and I like an army shirt, it is green. So irrespective of the fact who's wearing it, it has to be, you have to see a green patch. which has been monotonous and just been like in a parade or something.
Yeah, ideally, an army thing is supposed to be a camouflage. Even when they come to the city, yeah, so they still maintain
that.
If they want to camouflage, why don't they just wear office clothes and come as an army?
So, office again, it is a camouflage. No? So, if you go to a multinational company or something, so they will have to follow some kind of a decorum to themselves or something, where everything is being strict, cut to cut. Now I was trying to break free from it. Yeah, so like break free as in follow a timetable.
So you are talking about
so make fun of a timetable, not fun of a timetable, but you know, you make your own timetable.
You're talking of now it makes sense. Now you're talking of breaking free from something that is made by a system.
Yeah.
So say that. We can delete it.
To kind of, you know, I would also like to say, I mean, if it is, if you want to change something or maybe a system, you have to always be a part of it and then see how it rotates and then suddenly just break free of it.
So then the work is started. Basically, you're actually working every day in this format so that you break free from yourself also.
So break free, Abhi recently, I mean, I was not a part of a school where there were no costumes, there was a uniform you had to follow. So it has been changing now. I mean, I don't blame these schools for having the same uniform, but their idea was very different, you know? Every person, every kid who comes to the college or a school, they are from a very different background. So it was also for the unification, and rather like no one feels bad about, okay, oh my god, this fellow is wearing something else which is much cleaner or which is much, we can afford it or something on those levels. Or, you know, fuck, I was scared, I thought teachers are here. So now this setup itself for me is something so khatarnak, you know, like inside a studio, you're sitting somewhere where you are not supposed to, as in staff room, like, you know, where teachers are supposed to be there and look at the kids.
But then consider yourself looking at your past.
Yeah.
I mean, you basically are in a dominating position right now because you have moved from there to a gallery. You are
slightly. We feel as if we are dominant. We can be like the dominating part of the art idea. But it is not like that. I mean, I don't think I can dominate something even now. As in, even in my future, if I keep continuing and I keep making work, keep making art, it's not something like I would like to dominate something or.
No, it's not that. I'm saying that these students right now are working. Might tomorrow spread the idea that you will pass out. Have come and tomorrow they see the video, they will get a feeling of the possibilities to not come up here. Hello, Chinmay, I'll just call you back. I'm in the middle of an interview. I'll call you back. I'm in the middle of an interview. So, you are essentially you are on top. You have overgrown from that.
I mean, I've done this and then now I can say I didn't like it. So, I mean, not like it as in, no, I would say none of these students would like to, or art students or any kind of students would like, you know, they none of us would like to be judged by someone.
Nadira.
Yes.
5 more minutes.
Oh, okay. No.
Recording time. 5 minutes. Sorry.
Huh.